Joanna has a question here. When watering the 10.32 wet food patch, are there any concerns about health risks or interactions with soap or grease in the water being applied directly to these food crops? I was under the impression that some processing would be better, or that less cleaned grey water should be used for tree crops. Okay, so I'm sitting in a banana circle, which I've used for on aid projects in exactly the same way, but you're referring to the permaculture manual page 273. It has a feed line from a septic tank, you'll see in the diagram, into a large open pit. It's about 8 meters by 5. And on the bottom of the pit, it's about half a meter deep, you have a layer of rocks. So it's half a meter of rocks at the bottom of the pit. And then on top of that, there's lots and lots of either banana leaves or thick leaves or paper or cardboard. And then on top of that, there's a thick layer of mulch, and that's planted to comfrey and legume ground covers. And they're regularly cut and put to the mounds on the outside. There's no food in the middle. So everything's soaking through the mulch, through the paper, and through the gravel into the bottom of this big shallow pit. And there's a raised mound around the outside impounding it. And on the raised mound, not in the pit, there's papaya, banana, and pigeon pea. Well, that's very much like this big mulch pit I'm sitting on. It's over a meter deep. And there's these bananas are actually on a mound because I'm up raised above the ground on the pit that's overfilled. So they're growing on the mound on the outside. Now you can put grey water in here. I've done it many times. And if they're biological soaps, and they might be a little bit alkaline, the breakdown of organic matter and the humic acid created by so much mulch I'm sitting on is gonna compensate with its humic acid acidity to the alkalinity and bring it probably close to neutral. It could even actually help having a bit of alkalinity coming into so much humic acid breakdown. And grease is just got lots of embodied energy grease, and it heats up the compost when you put it in and improves the breakdown of the organic matter. So that won't be a problem. But the food crops are on the outside mound in the demonstration. They're not inside the pit anyway. So, there may be regulations wherever you are. If you're in the over-regulated world, it might be difficult to do. And the reason that it's got papayas and bananas on the outside of the pit is most of the time these systems we put into the under-regulated world when we're working on aid projects. Now, if governments fall over and we go into an unregulated type of world, then you need to know these systems work, because you're taking the mild pollutants of grey water after a septic tank into a soakage pit, which on the mound on the outside can grow quite good crops. But even so, the crops we're talking about, banana, papaya, and things like pigeon pea, they're all fast growing. They're not long term with roots that are going to go right into the pit. They're just sitting on the outside of the mound, getting that secondary soakage or the secondary moisture. Now, another crop that Bill talks about potentially being inside the mound is banana grass, which is a variety of Pennisetum. So it's like clumping cow cane, very, very prolific. But what he also says quite distinctly is that everything inside the mound is continuously cut and the foliage is taken to the mound. So inside the soakage pit, there's a continuous cutting. It's not let to go out of control and clogged up. It's continuously cut and the top mulch is taken over to the food trees or the fast growing crops that are on the mound on the outside. So it's a biological function of extraction through particular crops, comfrey, probably sweet potato. You might be tempted to eat the sweet potato. So ground cover legumes, comfrey, barnagrass, grass, things like that, regularly cut, extracted to the outside. And then on the mound, yes, there can be food crops, but they're not necessarily large trees with big tree roots that are going to go under the pit.